Yeah. You took me to our favorite spot, place we go to hang a lot. Something seemed to catch his eye. Oh, over my shoulder. Whoa, over my shoulder. I turned around to see what's up. A pretty young thing, sure enough. She was new, he wanted to know her. Know her. Oh, yeah, then she flicked her hair. Oh, yeah, he began to stare. Waiter, bring me water. Gotta make him keep his cool. Bring me water. He's acting like a fool. Bring me water. Oh, I did my best to block his view, but it was like he could see through me. I just knew he wanted to know. She's still standing there. Waiter, bring me water. I gotta make him keep his cool. Bring me water. He's acting like a fool. Bring me water. Gotta be a way to cool this clown. He's starting to embarrass me. I may even have to hose him down. Bring me water. I don't know what he finds so distracting. What's so odd about her? I really don't like the way he's acting. Bring me water. Bring it on. So hot about her. Yeah. I gotta make him keep his cool. Send him back to school. He's acting like a fool. Waiter, bring me water.
Hey everyone, it's Cheyenne, and that was Waiter, Bring Me Water by Shania Twain. This is one of the songs that I grew up listening to, and I have always loved this song, kind of respected it in a way, because essentially, from what you hear, it is about this woman who's on a date, and instead of being able to, like, have a, like, a conversation with her date, he's staring at some woman behind her, and so she's like, you know what? Bring me some water, because I gotta cool him down. And I think, if I remember, at the end of the music video, she ends up dumping, like, a whole pitcher of water on his head. It's hilarious. But I guess it's kind of like that thing, like, even if you know the person, like, even if it's just, like, friends, it's kind of disrespectful to, like, completely ignore someone just to stare at someone. It's like, if you bring someone to a place, you're there to talk to them. Like, I get it. You could be, like, if you're friends, then it's probably pretty cool to be like, hey, you know, that chick's pretty hot. But, you know, just completely ignoring them, she's like, you're really starting to embarrass me. But especially if it's a date, like, that's just not, don't do that. Don't do that. Not okay. That is a great way to get water poured on your head. Just saying. So I always thought this song was kind of awesome because, like, at any, like, dating situation, whether it's the girl or the guy, like, if you're on a date with someone, you're there to be with them, to spend time with them. So if you're paying attention to someone else, that's kind of, like, super disrespectful. Just super disrespectful. Like, if you don't want to be on a date with that person, then you shouldn't have brought him out in the first place. Just saying. But this is just kind of like a fun song and a little bit of a song where it's like, you gonna disrespect me, you gonna get soaked. I've given up on putting my jacket sleeve back up. I'm sure some of you guys are like, why doesn't she fix her jacket? Let me explain something. This jacket is pretty big on me, and I love that because I like baggy clothes. It used to be my brother's from when he was in, like, sixth grade, and he was a little overweight back then, and he's much better now. Like, he got an ROTC, and, like, he buffed up, and he got more of, like, he was too tall for these than it was, like, because, like, these would fit him, like, width-wise, but it would no longer have fit him height-wise. So he got rid of a lot of his old clothes, and him, as we were growing up and actually starting to, you know, get along, because for those of you who don't know, my brother and I used to say we hated each other. Like, we didn't actually mean it, but it was just this whole concept, I guess, of the two youngest siblings. He was my older brother, and I always got on his nerves, and he always got on my nerves, and so we would always, like, we would say we hated each other, but we really didn't. Like, when I broke my nose in fourth grade, he ran so fast to come and help me, like, when I was found on the playground, that he slipped in a puddle and got, like, his whole side wet, and then refused to leave the nurse's office until the ambulance or my mom, I can't remember if my mom ended up being the one to pick me up. She was working that day, and I remember the school was going to call an ambulance, but I was covered in blood. And when my brother got sick, I'd be bawling my eyes out. Like, we loved each other, but we got on each other's nerves all the time. But when we hit high school, we finally started getting along. But anyway, so when he was getting rid of his clothes, he knew I love wearing baggy clothes. Like, I'll wear tighter clothes now because when I got, like, I can't remember if it was, like, halfway through my freshman year or it was my sophomore year that my mom and one of my sisters was just like, you have to start dressing more like a girl. And that was just the way things were back then. They've kind of started to accept. And I've started wearing some less, like, some clothes that actually fit me. But I still like baggy clothes, and my family has kind of come to accept that if I feel like wearing baggy clothes, I'm gonna wear baggy clothes. Like, you can't make me get rid of my baggy jeans. So that is why this jacket kind of falls off of me. I could fix it, like, 200 times, and sometimes it'll stay on, and other times, like, I won't even realize it's fallen off. Like, actually, when I started this video, I hadn't even realized it had fallen off. But, yeah, so fun little story there. I love this song. Shania Twain has so many great songs. This is just one of them. I think her most popular one that even people who aren't really into country have liked was Man, I Feel Like a Woman, just because it's such a fun, empowering song for women, and it's fun to listen to. That being said, I'm sorry I blew out the mic a little bit, but it's like, couldn't help it. I gotta work on that. Or turn the sensitivity down a little bit at least. Anyways, the rights to the song go to Shania Twain and her producers, and the rights to the music go to Let's Sing Karaoke. If you guys liked it, please make sure to let me know. I hope you guys are doing well, and I love you guys all so much. Stay you, believe in yourselves, because you guys are absolutely amazing, and I mean that. Don't forget that. Don't forget to dance today. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you later. Oh, nothing happened to my finger, by the way. I just accidentally got blue marker on it. I don't know if you guys could see that. I just in case you could, nothing happened to my finger. Although, I did burn my other finger. Yeah, see that little burn there? Yeah. It's nothing serious. There was a little blister there yesterday, but it's not there anymore. I was cooking dinner, and my dumb butt decided to try and stir the potatoes I had in the oven without pulling the tray out. When, you know, I could have. Like, I knew I could have. I was just like, I'm just gonna try and stir it without pulling it out because I was being lazy. and I hit the oven burner once, and I was like, ah, oh, it's fine, I barely hit it. And so I kept trying to stir it, and then I hit it again, and I was like, okay, I burned my finger this time, let's actually just pull it out. So yeah, that's the person you guys might be just listening to all the time. I'm not always the smartest person in the world. If anyone ever thinks I'm the smartest person, that'd be pretty weird. Never been all that smarticles, just kind of average. That's pretty much it. I really don't know what else to talk about. Like, I'm super tired. I'm gonna go sit down, lay down. Oh, my cat, she's so adorable. I can't help it. She's over on my bed, just curled up in a ball. And she's all sleepy. It's so cute. I love my cat. She is like my saving grace some days. Like when I get into one of my depressive episodes, it helps to kind of have her there. Just because, first off, she cheers me up. She's fucking crazy. Just like me. And also because, like, if the thoughts that I have sometimes seem to be winning, it helps to think that, like, if I wasn't here to take care of her, no one would be. And that's a really, really sad thing to say, and I know it is, and I'm handling it. I've talked to my family about this stuff, and we are working it out as best we can. But it does, it helps me to think that, like, it's not like I don't know I have people. Like, it's not like I don't know that I have people here that care about me. It's that I just sometimes, like, life gets to be too much. I hate that I'm so stuck right now. And I blame it on myself. Which, I mean, really, if I think about it, it's my fault, so. But enough with all that. I'm okay. Like, I'm getting better. I have good days, I have bad days, and I'm dealing with it. But just know that I am getting better, and I'm definitely a lot better than I was a year ago. So that is a plus. Like, I can look back and I know that I am so much better now than I was then. But it's still, like, sometimes it's a fight, and I'm gonna win it. I'm way too competitive to lose, so don't worry about me. Once again, I love you guys so much. I'm sorry if I kind of upset you guys with any of that talk, but, like, I just wanted to say that I really love that animal behind me. Like, she's, like, such a blessing in my life. And, like, you guys are too. Like, I love, like, commenting back to you guys, and I love talking about just, like, some of the things that I bring up in my videos. Like, I love doing that, and so. Thank you guys. Really. Why am I... I'm about to, like, start crying, so I'm gonna go. Like, I don't know what just happened, but I'm gonna go. Love you guys. Be you. You're awesome. Bye.